guys, and welcome back to Jockstrap Sports. I am joined today by my good buddy Nick Bartek, based out of Flagstaff, Arizona. He's a big-time hockey fan, and he knows a lot more than I do. I know absolutely nothing about hockey. I don't really follow it during the season. I watch it for the fights. That's pretty much it. So Nick, go ahead and introduce yourself. Tell us a little about yourself and what we're going to talk about today.
How's it going, Adam? Pleasure to meet you. I mean, I guess via Skype-wise. Thank you for letting me be on the podcast. I'm happy to be your hockey guy. I grew up in Maine, so that's all we did was just play hockey. And I think today we're going to talk about the first and opening rounds of the 2019 Stanley Cup playoffs. Talk about the Eastern Conference and Western Conference, and see who we think is going to win the whole thing.
That sounds great, man.
So I guess first and foremost, we've got some close races in the Eastern and Western Conference, with Columbus barely making the very last and eighth and final spot in the Eastern Conference with 98 points, just beating Montreal, who just had 96. Columbus made quite a few trades at the trade deadline just a month or so ago, picking up some big names, and it seemed to be paying off for them because they're actually in. Because once you're in, you're in. Because, you know, once playoffs happens, you know, you can be a first seed, you can be a last seed. It doesn't matter. Once you're in the playoffs, anything can happen. With the Western Conference, we have the Colorado Avalanche coming in the eighth and final spot, just beating the Arizona Coyotes, unfortunately. But the thing is, they have a really good team. They were banged up for a little bit, but then they just got their captain back, Gabriel Landeskog. Beautiful Swede, by the way. And they're going to have to go ahead and face the Calgary Flames in the first round. We'll see. That should be very exciting. And what do you think we should talk about first? Should we talk about the Eastern Conference or the Western Conference?
You know, I say we go with the Eastern Conference, and because as little as I know about hockey, I did look up, like, the final, you know, standings, and I was pretty impressed with Tampa Bay's record. I mean, shoot, 62-16. That ties the best record ever in an NHL season. I know they had less losses, but it seems like that was because they used to accept ties. Or they had more losses. Sorry.
No. That's awesome. Thanks with the new rules now, like, there's very, very minimal ties because we go to a, as you know, we go to a 5-minute overtime, 4-on-4, and after that 5-minute overtime, we just go to a shootout until somebody wins, and whoever wins, they get that extra point. And Tampa Bay just happened to be the best of the best, best in the entire league. They obviously won the President's Trophy, which for those of you that don't know, that's the best record in the regular season. They finished off, like you said, 62-16-4 with an overall 128 points. Now, I don't care if you're a fan of hockey or not, that's extremely impressive because the next team happens to be the Calgary Flames, and they only have 107, followed by Boston with 107 as well. So Tampa Bay, they're just on a roll. They had quite a team built up thanks to Vincent Lecavalier and Martin St. Louis. You know, they started off a base quite a few years ago when they won the Stanley Cup in 04. And they built a team through trades, and I can tell you what, like, they're the team to watch. Everybody has their eye on them. They're fast. They have veterans that are seasoned. They have rookies that are young, and just their goaltending is amazing. I mean, when you have Steven Stamkos at the helm, you know, anything's possible with those guys. And then obviously with Kucherov, man, if I had hands like him, I would be in the show, without a doubt. So in the Eastern Conference, we got the first round, like you said. We have the number one Tampa Bay Lightning facing off against the Columbus Blue Jackets. Now, like I said, the Columbus Blue Jackets just got quite a few trades before entering the playoffs. They got quite a few players, including Matt Duchene. Longtime Colorado Avalanche, played for Ottawa for a couple seasons, and then very last second just came to Columbus. They got their leader, Nick Foligno, great player, tall, from Buffalo, New York. And then, of course, they even got Adam McQuaid from Boston. So that was a very good trade for their defense. And of course, their goalie, 6-2 Sergei Pervotsky from Russia. He's just been on fire lately. Like, yeah, they have three other backups, but he's the one that's been carrying all the weight. And so we'll see that pretty good matchup in the first round for that one. The next one I have is between the Boston Bruins and the Toronto Maple Leafs. Now, Boston came in second. Like I said, they finished with 107 points. Obviously, they're my favorite team because, you know, I grew up watching Patrice Bergeron and Raymond Bourque and so on and so forth. I really wish they could relive that match in 2011 when with Tim Thomas. But it's going to be a really difficult challenge just because the Toronto Maple Leafs, they are not the team to mess with. Toronto, as if people don't know, they got a huge trade by getting the best player for the New York Islanders, John Tavares. And he was a superstar with that team. And then training in Toronto is huge. So now we have this young core team of players with Mitch Marner, John Tavares. You can't stop them. They're fast, they're quick. And then they got seasoned veterans from Patrick Marleau, which they got a few years back from San Jose. They're not messing around, and they definitely have some little rivals with Boston, especially being eliminated by Boston last year in the Stanley Cup playoffs. Okay. Moving further along, we got the defending Stanley Cup champions, Washington Capitals. They also took the number one seed in the Eastern Conference, and what I mean by that, I mean the Metro Division. Obviously, you have Alexander Ovechkin, who's just absolute fire, especially on the power play. You got Brandon Holpe. You know, he's been probably one of the best goaltenders you probably have this year, and their team just really seems to click. They're really good at home. Great home ice advantage. But they're going to face a team that I don't think they're really familiar with in the playoffs, and that's with the Carolina Hurricanes. Now, Carolina Hurricanes. Nobody suspect them to be in the playoffs. They haven't made it for a while. You know, they have some good talent, but they just needed a leader. And luckily, they got Game 7, Justin Williams. He became their captain. He did some really work with that team. They've pulled off some magic. And, you know, having some great veterans like Jordan Staal and Brock McGinn, you know, that brings some talent. And then, of course, having Justin Falk and Trevor Van Riemsdyk from Chicago, they've both doing really, really good. And if you haven't watched these Carolina Hurricanes, like, you need to watch out for them because they have some talent. They have some potential to knock off the Stanley Cup champions. Last but not least, we got the New York Islanders and the Pittsburgh Penguins. Now, Pittsburgh Penguins, as we know, at one point in time won back-to-back Stanley Cup champions, obviously with the leader at helm, Sidney the Kid Crosby. Of course, you know, you got Evgeny Malkin and Phil the Thrill Kessel. What an offensive threat that they have. They have chemistry. They have flow. They're getting a little older, though. That's the only thing I worry about. And just they're working really hard, but I don't know. They're just getting older and older by the second.
Yeah, I don't know now, if Sidney Crosby's nickname, the Kid, really fits anymore.
I know, because, that's what I call him. That's where he grew up. I mean, yeah, you have to respect the man just because he's literally won every single trophy that you can win in the sport of hockey. I mean, he already has the Triple Crown, which is he has a gold medal in the Olympics. He won a Stanley Cup with Pittsburgh Penguins, and he won World Junior IIHF with Team Canada. So he literally has that. He has... I think he has a Rocket Trophy as well, but don't double check me on that. But either way, he's just a phenomenal player. He can work with everybody. He works. He gives out 110% each and every game. You see it. So, I mean, if he wants it bad enough, he'll do it.
See, I feel like Sidney Crosby's probably my least favorite player because, what was it, the 2012 Winter Olympics?
2012 Winter Olympics?
Was that or 2010? I don't know. Whenever it was that overtime goal against the USA and knocked them off in the finals.
Golden goal. Yeah, that one definitely hurt.
Yeah. Yeah, that's why I choose not to support him. But hey, that shows how much I know about hockey.
No, he's a phenomenal player, but you can love to hate him just because he's just that good.
Oh yeah. Definitely understandable.
Yeah.
So who do you like coming out of the East then? You know, with these eight teams, if you had to pick two to meet in the conference finals, who are you taking?
Ooh. Well, I already have several brackets brought out, but I honestly think, I know we even haven't got to the Western Conference yet, but I believe that whoever comes out on top in the Eastern Conference is probably going to win the whole thing.
Okay.
And I really wish the playoffs bracket was done a little different, which a lot of people have been complaining about online and so on and so forth, just because they wanted to mix up a little bit, just because, for example, on one side of the Eastern Conference, it's Tampa Bay, Boston, and Toronto. And those are my top three teams that I think could probably win it. But we know that two out of the three are going to be eliminated even before making it to the Eastern Conference Finals.
Now, is it a true bracket system?
Yeah, it's a true bracket system. It's, like I said, it's 1 versus 8, you know, 2 versus 3, and then, like, 1 versus... Wait, no, I screwed
up. So 1 versus 8, 2 versus 7, 3 versus 6.
Yeah. And that's how it goes. But the thing is, like, some people are really upset about it. Some people just want to do, like, a round robin. I don't know. That's not... This is probably the most grueling 3 months that any NHL or professional hockey player has to deal with. It's 3 solid months of just day in, day out work, giving an 110% effort. You know, sometimes no breaks at all. Like, to get all those wins and to make it to the Stanley Cup, even alone, is just... takes a lot out of you. So I think this is good with what you have. Yeah, injuries can be difficult, but you've been worried with injuries throughout the entire season, and you know the regular season doesn't stop if you have an injury or anything like that. You know, you just got to keep pushing. And I think now these days, since the league is a lot faster and more offensive, you definitely need to have, instead of just having one or two solid lines, you got to have 4 straight solid lines day in and day out, especially if you want to make it deep into the playoffs.
Okay.
Well, so I guess my answer to that, I guess I'm just going to have to go with Tampa Bay. They haven't put their foot off the gas. I mean, like I said, the next closest team had 107 points when they had over 120. That's just unheard of. And like you said, it tied a record. So I don't see them stopping. I think they beat Columbus in 6, and then if they face Boston, Toronto, maybe 6 or 7. And then if they do go to the Eastern Conference Finals, they'll probably either face Washington or Pittsburgh, and I think they're just too powerful, and I think they'll represent the East.
Okay. You know, I completely understand, just basing off the records. I mean, seeing what they've done all season long is pretty impressive. So I don't doubt what you're saying.
And just like I said, they're a team that has, you know, 4 solid lines that can go in, day out. I mean, their whole team is stacked. If you look at it, I mean, Ryan Callahan, Anton Erin, Tyler Johnson, Nika Kucherov. Like I said, Kucherov, you'll be hearing that name a lot, I guarantee you, in these playoffs, because he's on a hot streak. He's scored, I want to say, at least 40 goals this season alone. I mean, let's see. 82 games played, 41 goals.
Wow.
87 assists, 128 points. That's just this season alone. That
87 assists?
87 assists.
Wow.
That is insane. His plus minus is 24. I mean, this guy is on fire. And even if he didn't have the team that he probably had around him, he's small, he's fast, he's aggressive. Only 5'11", but man, this guy can skate, he can pass, he can shoot, and he can score. So
sounds like
definitely
it.
Watch.